Hello, Internet. Welcome back to the Data Mining with Azure Machine Learning Studio by Data Science Dojo. Today's video, we're going to go ahead and create an Azure subscription. We're going to create an Azure ML workspace within that subscription. We're going to go ahead and explore the features within that Azure ML workspace. And if you already have an Azure ML workspace, go ahead and skip this video and go to the next video where I jump straight into building experiments, importing and exporting data. Okay, so the first thing we're going to need to do is we're going to need to get an Azure free trial subscription. The first thing you can do is you can either type in this link. Okay, you go ahead and pause this video and type in this link to your browser, or you can just go to a search engine and then type in Azure free trial. And it should be the first link that shows up, right? So azure.microsoft.com/azure/free-trial. All right, so go ahead and click on that. And then it's going to go ahead and say start free trial. You will be prompted to log into a Microsoft type account now. So that is like email that is like at live, at Outlook. I believe Gmail is supported, so you can try that as well. All right, so this is the first time you've ever signed up for Azure. Notice that you'll be brought to this page where you will have 1 month that is a free trial, and you will get $200 of credit in that first month. Okay, so whatever one hits first, whether it be 30 days or $200. All right, so when signing up, you'll need two things. You'll need a phone number and a working phone. With that phone number, they're going to text you a verification code. The next thing you'll need is a credit card. Okay, so they need this to verify your identity to make sure that you're not a bot making subscriptions to then create more subscriptions to make more bots. Another thing is they're trying to make sure that you don't go from month to month with a different email getting free Azure stuff for free. All right, so they're not going to charge this credit card at all. It's just going to be used to verify your identity. Now, those of you, I think, who have banks in China and India might get charged some kind of $1 verification fee. That is dependent on your bank, I believe. All right, so once you have your Azure ML subscription, to log into that subscription, you would go to portal.azure.com. So I'm going to go ahead and paste that into my browser. Now, you can go ahead and just go to a search engine and also just type in Azure as well. It would be, it's azure.microsoft.com is what you'll be sent to. You can just click on the portal at the top. All right, I'm just going to go ahead and log in right here. This should be a screen that you should see when you log into your Azure subscription. So notice this is our main dashboard. This displays a bunch of tiles that is very akin to Windows. So what we're going to go ahead and do now is notice that these are all the app services that we can go ahead and spin up in the Azure service. But we're here for a very specific service, and that is Azure Machine Learning Studio. So to make a new workspace or to make a new anything in Azure, go ahead and click this new button on the top left-hand corner of your subscription page. So go ahead and click new. You're going to type in and search for a service called Machine Learning. And once that is there, you're going to look for something called Machine Learning Workspace by Microsoft. Okay, so click on that, and then you'll get a brief description about what Azure Machine Learning is. Go ahead and then click Create. Okay, so you'll be then prompted. And so this is this thing over here that just popped up. It's called a blade. So in this blade, you'll be prompted to enter in a bunch of information about this workspace that we're about to create. All right, so you get to name the workspace. So I'm going to go ahead and name it, Fook Workspace. Yeah. I'm going to go ahead and, so if you have multiple subscriptions, which I do, you'll see this drop-down box over here. If you only have one subscription, you probably won't see this subscription here, but it lets you basically pin this Azure asset to that subscription to be billed to. All right, so the next thing is we need to basically pin this to a resource group. So you can use an existing resource group or you can create a brand new one. So what a resource group is, it's a logical container that binds cloud assets together for billing and automation purposes. So the idea is you would pin a bunch of Azure assets that are doing the same task or the same job or for the same project to the same thing. Think of it like a folder, but for your online cloud-based assets. So the idea is if you delete this resource group, it deletes everything in the resource group. It's all built together, and it's also automated together. So you can spin up all up at once if you know how to do PowerShell scripting or things like that. For new users, you tend to not care about what this resource group thing is. Just go ahead and create one. So I'm gonna call, I normally like to name my resource group the same thing as the thing as the same name as the asset, okay, that's contained in it. So I will call this workspace resource group, okay? And then you'll be prompted to which data center do you wish to use. So the location of the data center matters if you need to take in a lot of data or if you need to output a lot of data. Okay, so normally you are not really charged much for bringing in data to the cloud, but you're charged a lot for actually taking data out of the cloud. So I would recommend that wherever you want to consume the final output of the data is where you should go ahead and set the data center to be. So because I want to do everything in the US, I'm going to go ahead and select Central US. And then it's going to ask us to create a new storage account. So the storage account is a separate service within Azure. It's called Azure Blob Storage. And what this is basically cloud storage. Remember, you're getting charged about 2 cents per gigabyte per month to store something in here. So this is where all your data is going to be backed up to, and this is where all the Azure ML experiments are going to be saved. Now, if you delete this works, or if you delete this storage container later, it's going to go ahead and your workspace won't be deleted. It will just error a lot because it no longer has the data it was referring to. Okay, and the name of this workspace will have to be a globally unique name. Okay, because this will become a URL for your cloud store. So think of it like a domain name, like pizzahut.com or something like that. So this check mark over here will tell you that it is free and clear to be used. It all has to be lowercase, and all has to be in letters, no symbols, no numbers, nothing. All lowercase and just text. Okay, so it's gone ahead and named it for me. So Fook Workspace Storage. Okay, I'm fine with that. And then for the pricing tier, I think you can just leave that as standard. I think it only has standard right now. I think they're beta testing some other tiers right now. And then we're gonna go ahead and for the web service plan, unless you really know what you're doing, don't set anything here. And basically what this is it will set when you deploy web services, you're picking what kind of tiers of service you want for that web service. How many, how robust do you want that service to be? How many people and transactions do you want it to support? For the most part, the free one is fine, where we have 1,000 transaction is fine. Okay, so we'll create a brand new web service plan for that, and we'll select that as a tier, which is no pricing. We'll select the standard tier, which charges us nothing. But we only get 1,000 API calls, which I think is more than fine, especially if we're just prototyping. Okay, so once we filled everything out here, I think that is, we're good to go. We will want to pin this asset to our dashboard. So remember those tiles we saw at the beginning? That's where we want our asset to be, so we can always refer to it later. So go ahead and click the create button now. So this will take about 2 minutes to create. Go ahead and do something else for those 2 minutes. You will see a tile that has now appeared because we selected that button that says pin to the dashboard. And this is going to spin for the next 2 minutes. All right, looks like it finished creating and it automatically brought me into the asset. But if you don't know how to get back here, if you're on the dashboard, you can just click on the tile that was pinned. So click on the tile and you'll get back to this page. So this page lets you basically manage the Azure asset that is the Azure ML workspace. Now to get to the workspace itself, you will click this button under additional links that says launch Machine Learning Studio. Now, what I actually prefer is this actually goes to a separate website. So you can actually go to Azure ML by just going to studio.azureml.net. That does the same thing. So if you take this URL and paste it into your browser, it'll take you to the same place as clicking this button. So I actually prefer this URL because it cuts out the middleman, right? Because the idea is, all right, I have to log into Azure, and then once I'm in Azure, I have to find my asset. I have to click on my asset. Once I click on my asset, I have to click on this Launch Machine Learning Studio. Or if I just want to use Azure ML, I will just go directly to this URL and I'll cut out Azure altogether. I'll go directly into Azure ML Learning Studio. Okay, and that's just a tip that I'll give to you. All right, and it's gonna ask you to sign in again. it will share your Azure subscription, so that's fine. So go ahead and log into your Azure subscription, but this time do so by logging into your Azure subscription. So notice I'm inside of Fook Workspace. So that is the name of my workspace. So notice that you can have lots of different workspaces. So notice that you can select different regions and things like that. So there's nothing stopping you from having lots of workspaces, okay? So you can also change workspaces up here. So notice I don't have anything in West Central US, but I think if I go to South Central US, I have four other workstations I can select from. So notice these are all self-contained workstations that have either been A, shared with me, or I'm hosting them on a separate account somewhere. Okay, so let's go back to our current one. So that's how you switch workspaces. Now, the reason for this is if you go to, for example, this setting button over here, okay, you can invite users to your workspace, okay? So the idea is if you have a team, if you're working on a project, you can invite you make a new workspace and invite all your team members to that workspace, okay? And that will be a self-contained workspace. So this is the closest thing that we data scientists have to a Google Doc right now. This is probably one of the coolest collaboration tools we've had in a while. So you can always do this. So I can invite more users, for example, and then I can invite my buddy Eric, right, at datasciencedojo.com, for example, and I can go ahead and make him a user. Okay, so now Eric can go ahead and log into this, see the same experiment, data, models, everything that I would see in this together. And then notice that if I want to switch teams or projects, I would switch the workspace. Remember, you charge $9.99 per workspace, so keep that in mind. Okay, so the data sets that you will bring into Azure will be saved here. They're basically objects. Any models that you train will be in here. There's also a new feature, which is notebooks. So a brand new way of programming that's taking the programming world by storm is notebooks. The idea of a self-contained environment that can be deployed to the web where you just code on the web, right? And then you can use almost any language that you would want to. And then you can share those notebooks or just expose them as web services, which is really cool. So right now it supports Python and R notebooks. So those are the primary programming languages right now in the open source world for data scientists. If you have any deployed web services, they would be here. But your bread and butter will be this guy right here, the experiments tab. So an experiment is what they call a file for data science inside of Azure ML. So just like how a spreadsheet file in Excel is called a spreadsheet, right? And a Word document is called a document. These are called experiments, okay? And then you can pin multiple assets together into what's called projects. So notice I can create a project, right? Name the project, and then I can pin various experiments, web services, and data assets to this project, right? So notice I can have multiple projects going on at the same time for the same team, and everything will be good. And how I got here was, see this thing in the top left-hand corner here? I clicked over, you can click here and click on the studio. So Azure ML actually has three other pages associated with it. For the most part, you almost always want to be in this studio mode right here, okay? And I think we're out of time for this video. Go ahead and watch the next video where I will go ahead and show you how to create your first experiment, import data, export data. And you want to see more videos like this in the future, go ahead and like and subscribe. And I will look forward to seeing you at our boot camp. See you next time.